All right, what's up, Internet? Today, I'm going to talk about the 8-Arc Fusion Arcade Stick. That's what you're looking at right now. I recently did a review of the 8-Arc Onyx Arcade Stick, which is that one. And I also brought out my TE Stick. This is actually a TE Stick that I won at Comic-Con. It's been modded, so you can't buy it like this. I got it, I believe it's a Marvel vs. Capcom 3 TE stick, and I think the buttons and ball top have been changed, and they also added a plexi, which is all black, so nowhere on the front does it say anything, you know, like about TE sticks or Mad Cats or even a game, which is what I've mentioned before that I prefer when it comes to the appearance of an arcade stick, but it's kind of irrelevant because you can't, you know, really purchase this arcade stick like this, so you know, just letting you guys know why it looks the way it does. So anyway, when I did the review of the 8-Arc Onyx arcade stick, people were wondering, because I did mention the Fusion, and a lot of people were asking me, you know, for a review of it. So, that's what I want to talk about today. Let's see, where to start. The differences between the Fusion and the Onyx. First of all, the Fusion does not have a detachable cable. So it has, on the side here, it has an area for you to wrap up the cable. Now, the interesting thing about this, you know, you kind of have to compare it to the TE stick, because the TE stick is now, like, the standard to which all arcade sticks are kind of judged, because everyone loves it. And so you kind of have to look at it to compare anything new. When you compare this area to put the cable in, as you can see, it's very nice and roomy. And I don't know if you guys own a TE stick or not, but for the TE stick, you kind of have to be pretty precise when you're wrapping up the cable. I'll show you right now. The area to put the cable in a TE stick is pretty cramped. I mean, you know, you really got to wrap it up, you know, legit to get it in there. And that can be frustrating. So that's a plus when it comes to this arcade stick. And it also has the same felt bottom that the Onyx has. So an interesting story about this felt bottom. I was talking about in the review for the Onyx, I was talking about how this can be a major problem in tournaments. And, you know, I think it's a great addition to new arcade sticks. In fact, I think that all arcade sticks should have this type of felt bottom now, because I just think it's an amazing advance, and it's really functionally great. So I was at Devastation last weekend, and I had taken this arcade stick, the 8-Arc Onyx, and a lot of people were wondering about it, and a lot of people wanted to try it out, so I let a lot of people use it. And a friend of mine, Rixta, he was using it, and he said it was on his lap, and he wanted to pull it down. And when he tried to pull it down, it almost pulled his pants off. So the moral of the story here is that this thing is not going to slide around on your pants, you know. And that's really cool. That's really what it's supposed to do. So I really like that. It has the felt bottom. Now, you know, the important thing to remember about the Fusion is that it comes out of the box dual modded. So it will work on the Xbox 360, PS3, and PC. When I first mentioned it, there were people that were mentioning that this is just another version of the Quamba Q4 arcade stick. And at the time, I wasn't too familiar with that arcade stick, so I did some research. And there are some differences, but there is one difference that's a major difference. So, first of all, the differences are that this one apparently comes with a wraparound ear headset, which doesn't really matter to me because I don't even own an Xbox, so I don't really care about that. The Quamba Q4 has a handle somewhere around here that, you know, it's to carry your arcade stick, which I think is kind of gay. So that's, you know, not very appealing to me. But most importantly, the Quamba Q4 has a start button right here. That has to be just about the stupidest fucking place in the world to put a start button. I mean, you might as well put it right fucking here. You know? I mean, I don't know if you guys are tournament players, but the last thing you want to do is have a start button anywhere near, you know, and especially it's a Sanwa start button. So, it's like this big. You know, and it's Sanwa buttons, if you're familiar with them, they're relatively sensitive and they'll register if, you know. The main reason why all these arcade sticks, you'll notice, they don't use face Sanwa buttons anymore as start or select buttons. The reason for that is because when you're hitting an arcade stick downward, there is the potential possibility of having an accidental, you know, register of a start button. And especially because most of these arcade sticks have a plexi or some kind of art over a metal, like, under, like, plate, the metal resonates vibration. So a lot of people, they like to really hit their buttons hard, and there is the potential of hitting the start button accidentally. And on top of that, there are scenarios, like, if you're mashing in some game to maybe mash out a super, or, you know, let's say you play Tekken, and you get hit by a giant swing, and you need to mash out of it when you hit the ground. You know, if a start button's right there, and I'm mashing out of a giant swing, you know, I could push the start button, and that's not appealing. So, I don't know if that stuff really matters to you, but it matters to me, and I think the start button in that location is a really bad location. So, other things about this arcade stick, it comes out of the box, unlike the Onyx, with white buttons and white ball top, still all Sanwa parts. The case is plastic, similar to the TE, but the weight of this arcade stick, I believe, is 9.5 pounds. The TE stick, for cross-reference, is, I think, 6.6 or something like that, and the Onyx is, like, 10.5. So, these two arcade sticks are relatively heavier than the TE stick. So, when you're playing on them, you really feel like you're playing on a very solid arcade stick. Especially with the felt bottom, I mean, it really feels like as close as you can get to the real deal. And I like that. Let's see, what else am I missing? Oh, an interesting thing about this is, so it has these indicator lights right here, telling you what controller you're plugged into. And depending on what system you're using, if you're using Xbox, the lights will be blue. And then if you're using PS3, the lights will be red, which I thought was kind of cool. What else am I missing here? It comes with the two button plugs again and the wipey thing. And it is a mirror finish, as I mentioned before, just the same as all the other 8ARC arcade sticks. It's a mirror finish. And I believe it costs $189.99 for a dual mod arcade stick. I think that is a great deal. And I think that they will be selling a lot of these because it feels really good. And it's very comparable to a TE stick. TE sticks are kind of old now. They've been out for a little while, maybe 2 years. I'm not sure exactly when they came out. But you can imagine that a stick that just came out would have something new to bring to the table, and it does. So, though it's kind of harsh to compare it to a TE stick, since TEs have been out for a while, it doesn't matter because everyone fucking loves the TE stick. I mean, you can't go to a tournament without fucking tripping over one because they're everywhere. So, even though it's a little bit unfair to compare it to a TE stick, you still kind of have to because everyone, it's kind of the standard. And in this case, this arcade stick stacks up really well against the TE stick. It feels really good, very responsive. The light indicator things, that's a nice touch with the different colors. You know, no false registry of the start button. Nice and roomy side compartment for their cable. By the way, the cable, I believe, is 8 feet 2 inches long. So you got a lot of room for the cable. I mean, it's pretty hard to, hard to say anything bad about this arcade stick. You know, it does the job very nicely. And it has the headphone jack in the front. I hope I'm not forgetting anything, but yeah, it's a very solid arcade stick. I would say if you can afford it, you know, some people have asked me, should I, you know, spend $25 on this garbage arcade stick, or, you know, is this worth $30? I mean, you know, even if you're only semi-serious about playing on an arcade stick, if I were you, I would take that $30 and just save up and get something of quality. Because even if you don't like it, these are so desirable. Any one of these three are so desirable that you can sell them and not lose a lot of money. So, Let's say you go end up buying an arcade stick for $150 or $189 or whatever, and let's say you don't like it, and you know you're not happy with it. You'll only end up losing about $30 when you sell it used. So I mean, you're only going to end up spending, worst case scenario, $30 anyway. So I highly recommend that you save your money and purchase something of high quality. I mean, any one of these three are of high quality, and in this case, because these two are newer and they have features that the TE stick doesn't quite have, I would say that as of right now, my favorite arcade stick I'm using right now is the 8-Arc Onyx, but that's because I don't own an Xbox 360 and I rarely have reason to play on it. So yeah, this is what I'm using right now. I'm really enjoying it. This one is also very good. Dual mod out of the box. And you know, it works really well. So this is what I would go with as of right now. Both excellent arcade sticks. Anyways, if you guys are interested in more reviews and stuff like this, please feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel. And I think you can thumbs up videos. So thumb this shit up. And we'll catch you guys next time.